Hello and welcome to episode 1 of deValiante Plays As We Know It by Jaime Scribbles Games. This visual novel is part of Itch.io's bundle for racial justice and equality. This visual novel contains strong language and mature themes that may not be suitable for all audiences. Discretion is advised. Now without further ado, let's get started.
Okay, cool. So that means I'm going to have a content restriction on this video. Ashlyn Phillips. Let's see. I really would like green hair, but whatever. Nope. Can I not change? Okay. I guess I can't change. I'm Diva Phillips now. It was a tiny place. Much smaller than our house had been, but we wouldn't die here if the power went out during a dust storm. Diva, can you help me with this? Sure, just let me change out of these rags first. I changed quickly, and then I rushed over to open the tub with our very limited possessions inside. We had to leave a lot behind to come here. They had informed us of the limited space. My mother sighed and started to lift things carefully out of the box and place them on the various shelves that were provided. I miss all of our things already. I miss them too. We should try to stay positive. Mom sighed again and just shook her head. I suppose. Mom stood up and started organizing everything into an appropriate spot. I went to our new beds and began to lay out the provided linens. The fabric was soft and free of sand. I almost felt bad touching it. We had a bathroom, kitchen area, and separate beds. There was also a hinged table that could be pulled from the wall and small chairs that could be tucked away. On the wall by the door was a metallic intercom system with a tiny speaker. The floor was hard and made of vinyl that roughly resembled wood. I had stared at the shower for a while before realizing what it was. I showed Mom and we both watched the water fall from the ceiling as we twisted the knobs. It was incredible. There were even fake windows by the bed, featuring paintings of incredible landscapes with green trees and water, something I had only ever seen in books. It was small, and it wouldn't provide a lot of privacy, but it was safe. It was home. The crackle of the intercom made me jump. I looked at Mom, and we both looked at the small speaker. The voice was understandable despite the static.
In 1 hour, I need all new citizens to come to the community center for orientation. I hope you all found your accommodations comfortable and efficient. If anyone has any questions or concerns, please remember that we are always here for you.
There was a pop, and the noise stopped. I started to look over the map that had been in the welcome basket on the table. The layout was simple, but I'd probably get lost. I was used to wide open spaces, and here there were tunnels and paths all over the place. Explore to get your bearings. I stepped outside after telling Mom I would be back in a bit. She had only given me a distracted nod. The halls were buzzing with activity. People in and out of uniform wandering around. Doors hung open while people laughed, cried, shouted, and even sang. I noticed a sign on the wall pointing towards the community center, so I followed it. I turned a corner and ran into something solid. Oh. What? I stumbled a step back and hands clasped my shoulder. Are you all right? The man released his grip after a moment and studied me briefly, his words surprisingly gentle as his grip had been. Sorry about that. I should watch where I'm going.
It's quite all right, but you should try to be more alert.
He started to walk away, so I spoke up to stop him. Is this the right way to the community center?
You're heading to the newcomer orientation?
I was just trying to see if I could find it, and then I'm going back to get my mother.
That's a good plan. You're more likely to remember the location if... Oh.
He held his hand out to me.
Forgive me, I'm Dr. Micah Everett. You might see me around the clinic.
I'm Diva. Doctor?
Yes, that's me. I should have introduced myself earlier. Unfortunately, I was a bit distracted at the moment. He smiled slightly, so I nodded and tried not to show how thrown off I was by his polite tone.
I suppose I'll need to decide on some kind of job. They're supposed to tell me more at orientation.
Don't worry. They plan to have open houses for each career, so everyone can learn more about them. You wouldn't happen to have any medical knowledge, would you? We can use people in the clinic.
Do I have any knowledge?
Okay. Bringing the dice back out.
1, 2, 3, 4. I declare 4 more. 2. No, but... I do want to help people.
That's a noble goal.
Oh. Thanks.
It... is simply the truth.
I looked down at my hands, not sure of what else to say. I suppose I should get you back, let you get back to what you were doing. Sorry for running into you.
It was lovely meeting you, Diva. I'm sure I'll see you around.
He smiled and continued on his way. He had been a bit distant, but seemed friendly if you got past the formal way he spoke. I went back to following the signs until I realized they did indeed lay directly where I needed to go. I went back to get Mom, and then we headed to the community center together. A large Welcome to Camden banner had been hung above the doors to the community center. The room was noisy and crowded. There were chairs facing a small stage and tables lined with coffee and water. Bulletin boards were on the walls with various flyers and notices tacked onto them haphazardly. The stage held a podium in front there were two clean but vintage speakers. The man I assumed to be the mayor was talking to some security officers on the stage. He stood tall and easy, with a commanding presence. He looked important. I sat down in an empty seat with Mom and looked around. People were reacting to this new situation in a variety of ways. A woman near the back of the room was sobbing, and the man next to me was just staring blankly off into space. Mostly, there was an air of relief. We had been accepted. Chosen. We were safe now.
Safe in a cult!
The hush fell over the crowd as the man stood to address us. He was handed a small microphone, and we heard the familiar crackle of speakers.
Probably the mayor. It seems as if everyone has made it here safely. I'm glad.
He smiled and looked around the room.
You may know who I am, but allow me to introduce myself anyway. I am Rick Davidson, the mayor of Camden. I know a lot of you are scared, traumatized by your life on the surface. Now you are safe. Together, we can build upon the community to create something magnificent. A home.
He clasped his hands together and then held them up for everyone to see. There was some hesitant applause.
First thing you all need to know is that Candom welcomes you. He flung his arms out wide to motion towards the crowd, and there was more applause, stronger now. In Camden, we know the cooperation is the key to a comfortable life. This is why I must ask all of you to prepare for Camden Career Festival on Saturday. It's a yearly celebration to welcome you, and to help all of you find your place within our modest little society. Still pretty sure your society is a cult, but moving on. As for choosing your career, there are a wide range of options. Each department will be hosting an open house in the evening starting tomorrow. You are all encouraged to attend as many as you like until you find a good fit. We will need everyone who is capable to contribute, and in turn I am confident that we will continue to thrive. In Camden, together. The applause was much louder and more enthusiastic now, and once it died down, he continued to speak. If work or anything else is stressing you out, I encourage you to take advantage of the many relaxing pastimes available here in Camden. Most are free. Though many of your basic needs will be met, your career will earn you enough beads to purchase a wide variety of luxury items. Fabric, entertainment, liquor, and... Have any of you ever tasted an apple? People began to move through the room and hand out small red things. I looked down at it and shared a look with my mother. We had heard of apples. I'd even seen a picture of one once. I bit into the firm flesh and tasted sweet juice. I looked down at the glorious apple in my hand and heard my mother squeal in delight beside me. Incredible! I smiled at her and continued to eat while the mayor waited for everyone to settle back down. He then continued to speak, but I was stuck in daydreams. Apples? Nice fabric? It was also incredible. I glanced over at my mother. She was gazing at the mayor, completely enraptured. She clutched the apple tightly, only one bite missing. Mom? She only looked at me and smiled, nodding her head. Then she returned her attention to him. I glanced around the room and saw a lot of similar looks. If they weren't being directed towards the mirror, then to the red apples in their hands. Suddenly, everyone stood up and began to cheer. I joined in, trying to hide my confusion. He must have said something, but I had missed it. Mom, why are we clapping? He's amazing. He really is. I think he's inspired optimism in everyone. It's just wonderful. I guess. What are we going to do for jobs? Mom stopped clapping for a moment. I'm not sure. We'll need to attend those open house things. I wonder what kind of jobs they have. If there is a job for an apple taste tester, sign me up. I held up the apple core for her to see. She seemed to remember her own apple and took another bite. I'm going to try to say hi to our new mayor. You should walk around and mingle. Get to know our new neighbors. I didn't reply, but she had already started walking away. I sighed and glanced around the room. I kept trying to tell myself that this was my life now, but I wasn't sure if it was sinking in. It's because you have cult radar! It was weird to not be searching for food or watching out for strange shifts in the wind. I glanced around the room. There were some people who clearly weren't new here. They stood near the large bulletin board. So many people. The noise echoed really badly in here. I closed my eyes and rubbed the bridge of my nose. Mom was right, but did I really want to try talking to any of these people when I felt so on edge?
Alright. I know what we should do. But,
What I would do is probably try and sneak out so I don't have to talk to people. So what we're going to do is we're going to roll a d4. What a 2 is try to sneak out. 3 and 4 is check out the bulletin board. 4, check out the bulletin board. The area around the bulletin board was crowded. There were lots of flyers listing schedules, events, instructions, and also listing various positions for jobs and volunteers. Several very official-looking people were stopping people to talk. A woman glided through the crowd and stapled a sign-up sheet for something by the many others. She took a deep breath and then smiled at everyone. "I'm Miss Miller, but please call me Gloria. I run the Community Affairs Department, so if you have any questions..." Her voice protected over the nearby voices and got a lot of people's attention. She glanced around and caught my gaze, her smile brightening. Hi, Diva is..." I cleared my throat and tried again. "Hi, Diva, it's nice to meet you. Are you looking at the available positions?" Shit. She was still talking to me. Specifically me? "Yeah, and, well, everything. That looks fun." I pointed at a sign advertising a winter celebration. The idea of winter was foreign, but I had read about it in books. A long time ago, it used to get really cold, and sometimes frozen water would even fall from the sky. "Oh, that was my idea. I thought we could create new traditions in the community and use the archaic ones as inspiration." Her smile faded a bit. "Winter is a weird theme, I admit, but I thought it would be an interesting novelty." "It's good to keep people busy." "That's the whole point." She tapped her temple gently. "Times are hard, but we can't let it get us down." "That's true, I suppose." Her natural smile had returned somewhat. "Are you good with people? We always have openings in community affairs." Alright, D6 time. 1 and 2 is I don't know, 3 and 4 is not really, 5 and 6 is I try my best. 4, not really. "We don't socialize a whole lot on the surface." "Oh, really? Don't you have to communicate with others for, well, trade at least?" "Are you one of those people who were born down here?" "I suppose I gave myself away, didn't I?" "Yeah, so you've never been to the surface?" "Nope." "Oh, but I have to run. It was lovely meeting you, though. I'm sure I'll see you around."
"Yeah, of course."
She nodded and ducked back into the crowd, vanishing amongst the swell of bodies. I looked back at the board and made mental notes of the various flyers. I never remember it all, but I suppose I could come back later. I caught sight of Mom chatting happily with the mayor. I had no idea how she managed to get through the throng of people that surrounded him, yet there she was. Everyone was starting to leave, so I decided to head home. Mom would know where to find me. The tunnels were getting noisy. More and more people began to appear as they went about their daily lives. I picked up the pace. There were so many people, it just made my skin crawl. A little bit. A lot of people were looking at me with open curiosity. Something about me must be screaming surface. Maybe sand was falling out of my hair or something. I paced around the tiny room that was now my home and waited for Mom to show up. As soon as I had started to worry, the heavy door opened and she appeared.
"Were you waiting for me?"
"I want to go to bed, and I didn't want to lock you out."
"I have a key."
"No, you don't." I pointed towards her key that had forgotten on the table by a box of fresh clothing. Well, luckily for me, I have such a wonderful daughter.
Yeah, yeah. So how was the mare? You seem smitten.
She waved me off and dug through her clothing to find something to sleep in.
He's a nice guy, that's all. Are you curious about him? His family made this whole place, funded it and everything. He asks for nothing in return, just wants everyone to live a better life. Like I said, smitten.
Mom laughed and retreated to the bathroom to prepare for bed. I was already good to go, so I curled up in what was now my new bed and tried to be grateful for the nice blankets. The small space was unnerving, but I slept, facing out to make it easier on myself. I'd get used to it. I could hear her humming, and it made me smile. I knew I could count on Mom to get a crush on a guy our first day here. Her romantic escapades had gotten us into a bit of trouble before, and hopefully it wasn't something we would need to deal with here. Lights inside of our quarters blinked off, and I tried to get comfortable. Mom switched on her white noisemaker, and I closed my eyes. I had been shocked that she had grabbed such a thing, but now it was drowning out all the weird sounds that were echoing through the place. Luckily, this place had electricity, and the mayor seemed generous with it. Tomorrow, I would need to find something to do until I could go to a career open house. It felt strange to be sealing the cracks and It felt strange not to be sealing the cracks and watching out for a storm. But the door was sturdy and there were no windows. I was so exhausted. I couldn't have stayed awake all night, even if I had wanted to. My stress is pretty low. So I've met two of these people. I don't know who Eva, Jude, Sam, Tabby, Trevor, whatever standing is. I guess my standing as a person. Yeah.
Thank you for joining me for episode 1 of As We Know It by Jaime Scribbles Games. The next episode will be out shortly. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment letting me know what you like down below. Please no hate or spoilers, as I'm not above removing those comments and the people who make them. That's all for now, folks, and I'll see you next time.